Hello, good morning. Now I have decided to throw lights on registration formalities of a newspaper. So newspaper is one of the important commodity in the market, and newspaper is considered as a common man's university. There is a special attachment between society and the newspaper. So we cannot think of a society in the absence of newspaper. And there are a lot of questions. Normally, journalism department receives queries from the publics about the commencement of newspaper, how to start the newspaper, who is permitting authority, whether the local administration has any role in permitting the or in giving permission for the commencement of the newspaper, etc., etc. Okay. And with this background, let us discuss in detail the registration formalities of newspaper in India. Okay. So according to the rule, like politics or like business, any citizen of India is absolutely free to start newspaper in any part of the country, irrespective of whether it is aged person or a boy or a girl or an educated, rich, poor or any religion. That's not an obligation. So for example, Milind Desai was suffering from blood cancer at Gujarat. He was just 6-year-old boy, and his last wish was to occupy the post of editor of a newspaper. So he expressed it with his parents. So parents took it very seriously and decided to start a newspaper under the editorship of this Milind Desai. And accordingly, they started their newspaper, and Desai, being the editor of the newspaper, took it very seriously, and that became a very popular newspaper in Gujarat community. But unfortunately, Desai, due to the cancer problem, could not continue the paper for a long time. He died shortly, and later parents could not continue the paper according to the plan of the Milind Desai. But why I am telling this? Age is not a factor. Anybody can start newspaper in any part of the country. But the procedure is, applicant has to, and normally the concerned DC office, suppose for example if a particular applicant or aspirant want to start a newspaper in a place called Mangalore or Ujre or Belathangadi, etc., etc., that's permitted. Anybody can start anywhere. And the procedure is, condition is, he has to approach the concerned DC office for the collection of concerned application format. Format 3, application number 3, available in the DC office. And in the application, aspirant has to mention detailed information, for example. And the first of all, applicant has to provide details about him or about partners, about printer, about publisher, about the editor, language of the newspaper, size of the newspaper, price of the proposed price of the newspaper, and duration of the paper, content of the paper, etc., or nationality, language. These are all the important materials to be highlighted in the format. And very, very important is, applicant has to propose 10 titles without fail according to priority. And that's very, very important. Permission process or registration process in India is nothing but a kind of permission for the title. And as per the rule, there is no permission for the new paper editor to imitate the name of the existing paper. Copyright Act clearly says that editor has to propose a new title. Otherwise, there is no provision, and it may be rejected. It will be rejected. So that's why editor has to think various titles, and accordingly he has to mention it in the application. Then completed application should be forwarded through to DC office. And earlier DC was just a kind of bridge between the RNI and the applicant. Now the DC has certain powers to verify the background of the applicant, whether he is a criminal person, or is there any cases, or is there any problems, etc., etc. So DC has certain powers to verify the authenticity, and if it is satisfactory and if DC feels okay, then immediately DC forward the application to the RNI office, which is at Delhi. RNI office, Registrar of Newspaper of India, is the main institution to provide permission for the newspaper. Local administration or local panchayat or local municipality has no role in giving the permission, not at all role in interfering, or it is not like a business or opening shop, etc. So ultimately RNI is completely responsible for allotting the license. RNI is the important wing of Information and Broadcasting Ministry. RNI is also one among the 40 wings of Information and Broadcasting Ministry. RNI completely exclusively related to the number of newspaper, total number of newspaper and permission, allotment of license, etc., etc. So DC first of all forward the completed application to the RNI office. RNI office maintains a big list catalog, and that catalog gives the complete idea about the total number of newspapers in the country, language wise, circulation wise, region wise, etc. So all the details about the existing newspaper available in RNI office. So RNI office, once it receives the application for the commencement of a new newspaper, starts functioning to verify, starts its verification process along with the existing title, existing catalog. Then, and if there is any objection, if the proposed title is already existed in a particular place, then automatically moves to the second option, third option, fourth option, etc. So this is the important function of the RNI. And if RNI is happy, or in the sense there is no objection to give permission for a newspaper, then immediately it informs its decision to the applicant again through the DC. So, or in case if all the 10 titles are not eligible, then again RNI suggests the applicant to propose new title. This is the procedure. So DC again acts as a bridge between the RNI and applicant. This is the one procedure, important procedure. So if applicant is happy about the proposed title or permitted title, then again RNI, accordingly RNI in the next step allots license number with certain conditions. If it is Delhi, applicant has to start his publication within 30 days of the application, and if it is periodical, he has to commence it within 45 days of the permission. And another important condition is applicant or editor of a newspaper has to furnish, has to forward every printed issue of the paper to the RNI office without fail. Or if editor is planning to change, if there is any mood to change the language of the paper, size of the paper or ownership of the paper, everything, every small change has to be brought to the notice of the RNI office without fail. And for the violation of this rule, RNI has every right to take action on the editor. It has right to cancel the license of a newspaper. And if the editor is eligible to obtain license from the RNI, and accordingly he is eligible for certain privileges, and allotment of newspaper through the particular system like rationing system, central government provides subsidized newsprints to the concerned newspaper office based on its circulation. So licensed paper editor or permitted editor is eligible to claim the government newsprint. Allotment will be done annually, and accordingly he can claim it. And another important privilege is import of printing materials. And license holder editor is free or permitted, or he can apply for the import of special materials for the printing in a particular territory, and this is also the special privilege. And the rule clearly says that privately circulated newspaper cannot be sold in the market, and only registered paper editor has right to or is eligible or has permission to sell his paper in the market. And as per the RNI rule, every day editor has to publish the details about the printer, editor, publisher in the page. Either normally Indian newspaper contains this imprint, we call it as imprint, and on the last part of the last page of the newspaper. But that's not rule, and that doesn't mean that that's the condition. So editor is absolutely free to place this box anywhere in the paper, and without, if there is no, if a particular editor fails to publish this information, police department has every right to take action, and they can punish it or they can arrest it. And another thing is, if suppose defamation is one of the important points to be remembered in the publication of a newspaper, editor, printer, publisher, those names regularly appears in the newspaper, and one can drag the editor to the court under the law of defamation, and defamation case will be filed both on editor, printer and publisher. They are, both of them are equally responsible and accountable for the litigation. And once the public permission is granted for the publication of newspaper, editor is absolutely free, or managing editor or management of the newspaper is absolutely free to take decision about the distribution of the newspaper, and they can print, publish and distribute it in any part of the country without any prior permission. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, permission is there and distribution is allowed. So with this, I conclude this particular topic. Thank you and end all.